أهلا بكم، أنا your brother Amir. Welcome to the second Arabic lesson. Arabic will be made easy as I will help you to learn it with the fastest, easiest and the most funny way, hopefully. To learn the Arabic language, اللغة العربية, starting from the الأبجدية, الأبجدية or alphabet. Over the next few lessons, you'll learn everything there is to know about the reading and the writing and writing of the Arabic language. By the end, you will be ready to dive into the Arab into the world of Arabic literature and really accelerate your Arabic studies. Ready to start? Then let's go to the second lesson. Now it is time to take out your pens and papers. You are going to practice writing and follow up practicing so you can get used to the shapes throughout the time, basically. Alphabet contain 28 letters and their variations. Seeing them laid out like this might seem intimidating, but the trick is to take it step by step, letter by letter. Don't worry about how hard it looks. Now just stick with me and in a few lessons you see how easy it actually is. I have some really good news for you. Arabic is largely phonetic. This means words are pronounced exactly like they are written. Also, most Arabic sounds have counterpart in English. We use the similarity to English to tackle the Arabic writing system. Let's separate the letters into two types. The first type are the Arabic letters that have English counterpart, and the second, the one without. Here it is. C are the letters with English counterpart. The second section, the letters without English counterpart. However, hey, you can use letter 7 as the numbers being introduced as well in the Arabic typing or texting or something. It has been introduced since 1975, I think, by Saeed Aql, I think. He's a poet and a great man. Man lost him. However, hey, you can use an H, and you use 7. Khay, you can use KH, and I gave an example about Khay previously. Ta, you can use T, same like T above, the T. Zah, you can use TH. Ayn, you can use the letter Ayn, 3, number 3. Or you can use double A. In the Islamic books, they are using A and apostrophe to make the sound A. You have to practice on these letters in here, mainly those three. Yeah. Ayn. So they will make it A and apostrophe to make A. Ayn. Ayn, you can write it by GH. And fi, you can write it by an F. Arabic is a cursive language. That means every letter is the word connected to the letters before it or after it, before or after it. So every time I introduce a new letter, I will also show you how it's written in all its possible positions. Let's get to know the difference possible positions in Arabic. It is one of four: isolated, initials, medial, and final, except for alif, dal, re, zain, waw. Let's repeat them: alif, dal, re, zain, wow. Those letters, you cannot connect them to the left hand side. Basically, you can connect them to the right hand side, but not to the left. isolated, the letter has no letters before it or after it. It is the standard form we learn before, like alif, separated alif aside, standing by itself alif. So this is the isolated letter. Initial, the letter lies in the beginning of a word connected, so it's connected to the letter from the right, from the left hand side, and that means so you start the word with it, you write it at the beginning of the word. The letter after it, but has no letter before it. Don't be confused, because the Arabic written from the right to the left, not like English, they started from the left to the right. Arabic is from the right to the left. Medial is that the letter is connected from the back and the front, so it's in the, it comes in the middle of the word, so you can connect it like with a liaison from both sides. Final is the last letter in a word, so that's only connected from before it. Sorry, I'm still trying to to do it a little bit by little bit with you, so you have to bear with me. I'm learning with time, like you. I'm learning with you, basically. Exceptions of six letters we must learn: alif, dal, dal, re, zain, waw. The four possible forms for all the letters in Arabic. Those six exception letters do not have a district medial form, and are instead written with their final form without being connected to the next letter. Their initial form is the same as isolated form. As you see, as isolated is not alif, and you see that I put like a little dash or whatever they call it, before the alif, to make it like a liaison, like that I can attach any other letter with it, and I will show you shortly how it will be attached to it. So basically you put it like that, one is separated like that, and if you want to attach for it, you'll put like a little section to it, and you continue. Welcome to the to the words, to the letters. Yeah, as you see in here, alif, it doesn't have initial, and it doesn't have middle. So if it will be in the middle of the word, it will be written as a final, but you'll continue with another letter, but it will be separate than it. So you'll start by alif, and you'll keep going by, you know, at the end in here, you started b, let's say if you want to write b after it, you'll write it b by itself. You don't attach it to it. It doesn't make like that. Anyway, today we are gonna start with a few letters, because if we are gonna do it all, it will be problematic. You will not be able to do it in one go. So let's start with alif, b, t, th, and we'll get letter noon, because it's the same shape. It's the same boat shape, basically. Where the difference is, the dot is above the, let's say in here you have a B, the dot not at the bottom, you put it at the above. And we'll practice it just in here. And as you see, alif, look how they wrote it. You can put A or A, and you put alif like that. This is how you can write it or read it to give it the thing, the sound. So let's try to see if we can draw. Yes, red will be good. Let's see. So if we wanna use letter noon, it will be similar to b like this, but it will be like a boat shape and a dot in here. Well, I think we need to make it a little bit bigger. Sorry for that. Deal done. So you will make it like that, and you will put noon like that. So it will be similar shape. Yeah, we'll stop today just until here. Although I was preparing to go with all of them, I prepared them and everything, but I don't know, depends. If you tell me that we can go further, we can do it, we do, can do more. Anyway, so if we want, let's say this is noon, yeah? If we wanna add to it, let's say alif, if we wanna write alif, we simply put alif, very, like stick, simple alif. And this is will be N, if you want, in the Arabic language, it will be N. N in depends on where the vowel will be going. But if I end for end it with another alif, yeah? If I end it with another alif, as you see in here, I made a liaison and I put another alif like in here, you see? I made another liaison and it will be Anna. Normally you can see Hamzi on top sometimes, and this is the Hamzi. So you can see Anna. Say Anna mean I. Let's say Anna Johan. I am hungry. Basically I am, if you want. Anna, I am. I am, Anna, Anna Johan. I am hungry. Let's say, let's use some of these different letters. If you wanna use it with B, you can use it like that. B, and we add for it Alif, and that's a B, Ba, B, Bab. And that will make a door. So basically, this is at the beginning. This is separated. Yeah? So this is separate, isolated. And this is starting with is the initial. So you see, bab. Now, if we can use the letter ye, yeah, similar to the boats ones, but with a beginning like that, and it will have two dots at the bottom. We can put B, ye, T. Do you see the T? It will be in here. The ye will be here, two dots, or you can make it like that. Two dots, you can make them like that sometimes. And T, bait. House, that will make house. It's not easy to draw or write like that. So excuse me. So I'm trying my best with it. So you can put bait and that will be house. So you can see in here, B, Y, T. So bait. If you wanna put alif and B, and that will make Ab, father. That mean father. Ab mean father. You heard in the Bible you say Abba, and that's father, Ab. Or in other places you may read it like that. Abi, Abi. A, B, Alif, B, Ye. Alif, B, Ye, Abi. So, in another way, you can put, you can write. So basically, it's simple. You can write that. Let's say T, like that. Sorry for that. T. Counted as two, as I said, like we can make it double dots like that, similar. So yeah, T, you can start it with it like that. They're all similar. You can start with it like that, T, and you can make it like that, and you can make it T, and that's in the middle. And then at the end, you can simply make it like a little liaison and continue and make it T. Same thing like B. That's at the beginning, like as we said, B. Or Abby. Or you can use it in a different way at the end as well. So you, and here at the end, basically you can use, you use the ye. Instead, you can put the B and the B, and it will be. So basically, you lift it up, and then draw it like that, and you put a dot, or just a little bit up, and then turn it and make a dot, and that will be it. When it comes to the ye in here, you have to make it a little bit different, like that, at the end. Now, let's clear all that. Yeah. So. That's it basically for those letters. So basically we took ye too as well. Tha, if you as you preferred last time to read it as tha. Yeah. It's a similar thing. You can use it in a word, let's say like thumma, you know, thumma. This is meme, but I didn't want to go there yet. And this is a tha. Thumma, meme. You put it like that with a liaison, and you put a meme down, and this is thumma. So this is the same, similar things. And that's it. So basically, just try to practice alif, or at the end of the word, let's say. Alif at the end in here, you see. Alif with the ba. Ba. Bab. Try to practice stuff like that. Yeah. Yeah, and so you do T with two dots, or if you want, you can do the thing like that. It's like two dots. This is used, mostly used like that, not two dots, basically, in the Arabic writing, not typing, in the Arabic writing. In the Arabic typing, you will see two dots like that next to each other. So basically, that's it. And then if you want to put it at the end of the word, you make like little liaison, and then you put B. So as we said, ab. Like that. And for mother not to be upset, I will tell you how to write mother too. Alif. And meme, normally it will be hamzi on all of them. So, and if you say my mother, I will put alif, meme, and ye, ummi. Why say oh? Because there will be hamzi in here. And there will be dhamma in here, and that will be for another lesson. Anyway, let's go further. We'll read them again, the sounds like that. You will read the whole sound thing, the letters like that. You can get used to them. Alif, B, T, C, Jim, He, He, Dal, Dal, Re, Zain, Sin. You see dal, 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 re, zain, nothing in the middle. Yeah, not doesn't go in the middle, not in the So basically, either at the beginning, or it will be, even if it comes in the middle, that does not connect at the left hand side. So dal, dal, re, zain, sin, shin, sad, dad, ta, za. Sorry for that. Ayn, ayn. Please pay attention for ayn. Try to practice it. Ayn. Try to practice it with the inab. Where are you? Go back. Inab. Inab. Grapes. Inab. Ghain fi kaf. We'll go back to the all what we are trying to do. To all what we are, to all those, and but the whole thing that will to for you to get used to them bit by bit, not to go very fast, you know. Fe, kaf, kaf, lam. You see lam in here different than alif. You see it's connected from both sides. When you, while alif, if you put it like that and you connect it, it will look like lam. So that's why they don't connect it. They connect it from one side, but the second side, it won't. It will be you will be confused. You'll think it's a lamb. It doesn't work. It doesn't exist. So that's why it's not connected. Anyway, meem, noon, he, wow. In general, in here as well, there will be something lamb, alif, lam, alif. Those are as well in here, hey, wow, lam, alif, yeah. And that's why I said there is a few different letters extra than 28. Those, just to introduce to you the vowels, I didn't want to go for so fast. Skoon is to be the sound very straight, yeah. This one called skoon. How can I do it? Try to write it for you somehow. Skoon, try to read it like that. Skoon, fatha, fatha. So skoon is just a circle on top of any letter. Fatha, just like a line above it. Yeah, a line, and then that will make it ba. Yeah, you see, ba. Ba, without alif, you can say it ba, while in here with a kasra, this one called kasra, it will be b. There is no ye behind it to make it b. Now with a kasra you can make it b. With a dhamme you can make it bu. You see in here, B alif will make ba, but as well you can make it with a fatha, ba, and you can add it to it as well on some word, because to make the sound proper. Now B, you see here, B, in here you can make it B, in here you can make it B, it's the same, B, 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 in here they are making kasra and ye, they are making it with a little bit longer, but if you take off the kasra in here, it will be b, and it will be similar sound. It will see b. Boo. Dhamme. One more thing. It's something like a dhamme. You turn it like that, and you make it like that. Come back. You make it like that, and it's like a double of the dhamme. Yes, and we'll come back to that later on anyway, but I thought to show it to you, to introduce it to you. Yes, so this one, in here, like say ba bun, when you say ba bun, like in some words you need to ba bun, so in some words you need to make a, you know, depends on where you are using it, in which sentence, with when it's
when it's with what, you know. So you can say baboon, depends on what you are reading. Yes, this is how it is. Yes, so this is good as an introduction. Yeah, next time we'll go for it further, maybe, or the one after. Now it is time for me basically to give you the tips of it. So the tips, I'm not gonna read it. You can read it by your own time. The thing is, you don't have to learn it and to be everything like 100% with it. Yeah. With time, we'll gonna be together. We'll learn it bit by bit. There is nothing to learn it in one go, or to be worried about, or to simply just go ahead and stay with me, and we will make it. We'll make it little bit by little bit easier and nicer, and it will be better. But I don't want to be longer on this second lesson, because I think it's already longer time and longer. I don't want to make it too long. So thank you everybody for everything. Thank you for bearing with me, because I'm just really learning with you. So by the way, I wrote for you how you write Amir in here. And this is how you write it: Alif, Mim, Ye, Re, Amir. Soon, if you give me later on when we learn the letters, yeah, you'll give me your name, and I will try to give you how to write it, tell you how to write it properly, and we'll go through it. And we'll make it up through the chat or something, and we'll make it together. Yes, this is your brother Amir. Please subscribe to my channels. I have a few channels now, because they are trying to block this channel I made as Amir Zaidan, as they blocked for me Survivor by Jesus Christ. So I made a few channels and I'm working on them. Basically, as you know, the Amir Zaidan, and you'll find those links, you'll find them in the comment section, and I would really love to know your comments about what I'm doing. If I'm helping you, if I'm not, what's your opinion about it? So I have Lord's Grace. It's only about Christianity and everything about Christian's faith, everything about to teach basically about some saints, about some prayers, about Jesus, the Bible, or you know, everything about the Christianity. Help Muslims is for anybody, and seeking the truth is basically made similar to help brothers and sisters in humanity. If they need any help, or if they need any to know the Lord Jesus Christ and as their God and Savior. So please subscribe to my channels, and you can mail me for any to learn anything or anything about this course I'm trying to help you with, Arabic course. I made this email especially for this course. So please write me, or in the comment section. But if you need to write me or send me anything to write, you know, by email, this is the email you can use. Please write there, write for me, and I will answer you as fast as I can. And I will try to help with everybody to improve, you know. So by email, I think it will work really nice too. And here, it's from Corinthians, the first Corinthians 1:18. Just read it in English. It's really nice. Just read it from Corinthians. I'm gonna read it for you in Arabic, and you translate it in English. I'm not gonna translate it. فإن كلمة الصليب عند الهالكين جهالة، أما عندنا نحن المخلصين فهي قوة الله. كورنثوس الأولى 1:18.
The Lord Jesus Christ be with you and save you, you and your families. And this is your brother Amir, and see you soon. Bye-bye.